We believe that life on Earth began in water. Water is the source of life. Therefore, if we are to search for life in space, we should first look where water exists. And there's plenty of water here. Twice as much water as on Earth lies beneath these glaciers. If life on Earth began in the oceans, it is highly likely it might have started here too. But where is here? This is Europa, one of Jupiter's moons. If there is life beneath its icy surface, how will we find it? By sending a spacecraft there, of course. And just a few months ago, a spacecraft embarked on its journey to Europa. If you're ready, we're going on a quest to search for traces of life in space. If we were to search for living organisms in the solar system, Europa would be one of the most promising places. Why is that? Europa is one of Jupiter's four large moons. It's roughly the same size as our moon, though slightly smaller. However, its surface is vastly different. When we look at the moon up close, we see that its surface is covered with craters, thousands of them. This tells us that the moon is not geologically active, and its surface has not been renewed for eons. Europa, on the other hand, presents a completely different picture. Since it is so far from the sun, its surface is covered in ice. Unlike the moon, Europa has very few craters. It's surprising for a moon of Jupiter, a meteor magnet, to have so few craters. Instead, it has cracks and ridges, indicating that something keeps renewing its surface. There's another place in the solar system similar to Europa, Saturn's moon, Enceladus. Like Europa, it is icy, cold, small, and seemingly lifeless. Initially, Enceladus didn't seem particularly interesting until the Cassini spacecraft began exploring the Saturn system. During its mission, Cassini captured something extraordinary. Massive plumes erupting from Enceladus's surface, illuminated by sunlight. Cassini flew through these plumes and analyzed them. They were water jets, shooting kilometers high. Beneath the icy, seemingly dead surface of Enceladus, there could be oceans. What's more, this water contained the building blocks of life. Similarly, in 2014, the Hubble Space Telescope detected signs of similar plumes on Europa. Think about Earth. What immediately comes to mind? Land. I'm preparing this video from land, and you're probably watching it from a landmass as well. If anyone's watching from the sea, let us know in the comments. When we travel the world, we mostly traverse land. Even though it only covers a quarter of Earth's surface, there's three times as much water on our planet. In reality, Earth is a water world. Europa, however, is thought to have twice as much water as Earth. Where there is water, there could be life. That's why sending a spacecraft to Europa is so crucial. It could lead to groundbreaking discoveries. This mission, NASA's Europa Clipper, which launched a few months ago, has three main objectives: to determine the thickness of Europa's icy crust and how it interacts with the ocean beneath, to analyze the chemical composition of Europa's ocean and determine if it is suitable for the formation and sustenance of life, to study Europa's surface features and gather information about its geology. Let's reflect on this for a moment. As I mentioned earlier, Europa is very far from the sun. Even on the warmest days, temperatures there can drop to negative 200 degrees Fahrenheit. Doesn't it seem strange to find liquid water in such a cold place? And twice as much as on Earth, no less. Europa owes this to Jupiter's massive size. Jupiter, the largest planet in the solar system, has a significant gravitational influence on the objects around it. We experience a similar phenomenon on Earth, albeit on a smaller scale. Tides, caused by the moon's gravitational pull. Compared to Earth, the moon is tiny, and Earth is small relative to Jupiter. Imagine how strong Jupiter's tidal forces must be on Europa. These forces cause Europa to stretch and contract, generating heat in its interior. This heat allows Europa to maintain a warm core, enabling a subsurface ocean despite its icy surface. Some scientists even speculate that Europa's ocean floor might have hydrothermal vents like those on Earth, which are thought to play a crucial role in the development of life. However, the exact thickness of Europa's ice crust and what lies beneath remain mysteries. Solving these mysteries is Europa Clipper's top priority. In the 1990s, the Galileo spacecraft discovered that Europa has a magnetic field. This suggests the presence of a fluid core made of charged particles. Europa likely has an iron core, a rocky mantle, and a salty ocean. Europa isn't the only one with a magnetic field. Jupiter has an enormous one, which subjects Europa to constant particle bombardment. Sending a spacecraft to such a radiation-intense environment is no easy feat. Why, then, was Europa chosen over Enceladus, which is easier to explore and where water jets are confirmed? The decision wasn't based on a single reason, but several factors. First, it's faster and easier to reach Jupiter than Saturn. Saturn is almost twice as far from the Sun as Jupiter. Even the Europa Clipper, which launched recently, won't reach Europa until 2030. Additionally, there's a wealth of scientific data on Europa. While Cassini provided great insights into Enceladus, Europa has been studied extensively, raising numerous questions that require answers. The European Space Agency also launched the JUICE mission in 2023 to study Jupiter and its moons, including Europa, Ganymede, and Callisto. JUICE will arrive in 2031. Together, these missions will enable a collaborative effort to uncover more about Europa. Europa Clipper will rely on advanced instruments, including cameras, ultraviolet imaging systems, and magnetometers. These tools will analyze Europa's magnetic field, atmospheric gases, surface composition, and water plumes. They will also measure the depth and salinity of its ocean, the thickness of its ice crust, and the effects of Jupiter's gravitational forces. Europa Clipper will use Mars' gravity in February 2025 and Earth's gravity in January 2026 to accelerate toward Jupiter, reaching its destination in April 2030. Although this may seem like a long time, discoveries require patience and courage. If we want to shape the future, we must invest in it. Thinking not just of today, but of 5, 10, or even 100 years from now. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe and turn on notifications to stay updated on new videos.